How can we make sure that we have enough good quality food for the fast-growing global population? The United Nations have recognized this challenge in their Sustainable Development Goals. Also, national and local governments have a responsibility in securing food production and consumption. But how can urban consumers themselves support food and agriculture in their own cities? This is a question we will address in this video. Urbanization and rising incomes in many parts of the world, coupled with global warming and biodiversity loss, make providing food a complicated challenge. And in this video, you will come to know more about food and agriculture governance at city level and the different forms of co-creation involved therein. Traditionally, the rural areas around the cities provided most of the food consumed by the urban populations. Over the past centuries, these close connections have gradually disappeared. And especially large metropolitan areas import their food from all over the world, while farmers specialize and increase their scale to supply global markets. In this context, agri-food supply chains are becoming more complex and the distance between food producers and food consumers is becoming larger. Trade and distribution over large distances is made possible by the rapid development of ICT and the increased power and market shares of super and hypermarkets. Consumers become dependent on this global complex food infrastructure, a global food complex which is unique since it secures around the clock and around the world supply of a wide range of food products. However, this global food complex has also a number of downsides. It uses a lot of energy, brings along greater food safety risks, such as pesticide residues, and operates at a distance from or even out of sight of the urban consumer. It is especially the downsides of the globalized food systems which incite policy responses from both public and private actors. Urban farming, urban agriculture, and urban food are becoming strategic, highly valued, and increasingly popular themes for urban policies around the world. For instance, in 2015, 144 cities around the world signed the Milan Urban Food Policy Pact, declaring that they will work to develop sustainable food systems that are inclusive, resilient, safe, and diverse. And also the new urban agenda adopted by the UN Habitat Conference in 2016 makes explicit commitments to improve food security and nutrition. In numerous cities, both public and private actors, governments, producers and consumers have started to take action, as we will illustrate. Food governance and policy making at city level are taken up by actors and organizations both within and outside local municipal governments. Their activities include facilitating infrastructures for urban agriculture, promoting the prevention and reuse of food wastes, addressing obesity and food safety problems, as well as promoting access to nutritious food for disadvantaged groups of citizens. Cities such as Toronto in Canada and Belo Horizonte in Brazil are leading examples of urban food policies. These examples also tell us something about the nature of contemporary urban food policies. First, they include mostly fresh foods, such as vegetables. Secondly, they are popular among younger, well-educated urban citizens and consumers who appreciate and care about food. Thirdly, they create new labor opportunities for specific segments of the urban population. Four, they bring production and consumption of food closer together. And thereby, fifthly, they help to bridge the socio-cultural gaps between local and global food. In this video, we show how and to what extent urban citizens and consumers are co-creating the policies for the new emerging urban systems for food and agriculture, bringing them closer to the life world of the urban population. Producers establish more direct relationships with consumers. Civil society organizations and consumers are in different ways and to different degrees, involved in setting up and running parts of the new urban food system. For instance, as co-producers, consumers may become semi-producers when working in community gardens or urban greenhouses. They may find income opportunities here or satisfaction in producing local food with their own hands. As co-organizers, consumers may be actively involved in organizing and funding urban food production and distribution. For example, community-supported agriculture schemes or local food cooperatives. Co-politicians. Consumers may become engaged in developing municipal food policies to create the necessary infrastructure and political environment for urban food and agriculture. Co-inventors. Consumers may become involved in the identification and introduction of technological innovations and new producer-consumer links in urban agriculture, such as urban greenhouses. Co-creation involving consumers may take place at a very local level of running communal gardens in urban areas, but co-creation may also be global through worldwide networks promoting urban food and agriculture. These different forms of co-creation involving consumers in creating, transforming urban food systems have social and technical dimensions. It is interesting to analyze how both are combined in successful innovations. And as this video has shown, different ways of involving consumers can be important in aiming for more sustainable urban food production and consumption.